Jonathan Paula presents Game Time.
Greetings, Hotshot, and welcome back to the Uncharted Drake's Fortune Let's Play on the PlayStation 3. When we last left off, we finished up Chapter 6, Elena broke us out of this jail cell, and now we are driving on this Jeep, escaping from Eddy Raja and all of his goons in Chapter 7, Out of the Frying Pan.
Here they come!
Explosion! Oh my gosh!
Get out of here. Dun, 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 dun.
This is one of my favorite levels in the entire game. I love fixed track missions when you get to control something. Someone else is driving and you get to control the guns or whatever. There's a mission like this in a lot of video games, and they are always really, really fun because you only have to focus on a couple things, and it's very exciting when you can kind of just put your attention on one thing and not have to worry about problem solving. You just worry about kicking ass and taking name. Taking! I have to say, also, the scenery is awesome, beautiful, very exciting and thrilling. Just taking out palm trees here with my grenade launcher.
They're coming in from the side.
Good. I'm glad the camera switched over to this direction. I don't think I killed him. Did I do that?
Did I do that?
Oh, jeez. Look out!
Explosion!
Whoa! Alright, here we go, here we go.
Don't let him get you!
Oh man, where did they get those ATVs? Why did we hijack a shitty Jeep when they're driving around on awesome looking ATVs? Are you a fan of ATVs? I went once as a kid, and it was a lot of fun. I feel like that's definitely a hobby sport I could pick up when I get a little older. Or now. I mean, hell, I don't know why I don't. ATV's like, what, a couple thousand bucks? Relatively speaking, it's one of the cheaper hobbies to get invested into. My dad's taking helicopter lessons. That's like a $40,000 hobby. ATV, and that could be fun. I know there's a bunch of places in New Hampshire that you can go. Which is to say, just, you know, rural woodland and areas and stuff. What are you doing? Why are you executing a three-point turn on the edge of a cliff? Women drivers.
Just drive!
Better.
Look out!
Ah! Whoa! Look out! Dun, 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 dun.
They're behind us!
Yeah, no crap they're behind us. If they were in front of us, then we'd be in bigger trouble, wouldn't we?
Here's some of that for you.
Dun, dun, dun. You don't get to hear it a lot outside of like the title screen and a few like more cinematic moments, but the soundtrack in this game is actually really great. I love especially Uncharted 2 and 1. I haven't heard 3 yet. Again, I haven't played that one. But the soundtrack in this game is really pretty solid. It's, I would listen to it. You know, if you need good concentration study in music, pop in the Uncharted 1 soundtrack for a listen. There's some good tunes on there. Good kind of mood, atmospheric music, but it's pretty neat. Oh my god, there's a cliff! Thanks, Captain Obvious, I can see it. Can we just pull over for a second for the scenic view? There should be one of those pullovers right over here. They'll have some of those little telescopes you could drop a quarter into. I think they have a rest area, because I need to use the port-a-john. Oh no! That shouldn't have worked. Reminds me of Speed 1.
I can't believe that worked!
Yeah, see, I didn't either.
So who was that guy?
Eddy Raja. Jesus, who taught this woman to drive? Why is she driving headlong at full speed through the jungle when visibility's 4 feet in front of you? That's just reckless. Elena, learn how to drive.
Yeah, I'm fine. Oh, but you're bleeding.
Yeah, it goes with the territory.
Nah, it happens once a month. It's
Let's
normal.
Get the hell out of here.
Come on. Come on, Timberlands. You can do it.
Come on.
Referring to the boot, not the singer. How'd he catch up to us so quick?
Hey, Eddie.
Well, suck a dick.
Did you really think you could escape from what?
You're not French.
Oh,
don't
no,
talk like him.
Just giving the young lady the $10 tour.
Shut it.
My pants.
I bet you're working for them too.
What?
You thought you could set me up and keep everything for yourself.
I did think that, yes.
Get down!
Oh! My windshield, because we needed that.
Eddy, take it easy, buddy.
Well, you're out of luck now. And out of road. Now, give me that map.
I'd rather give you the middle finger. Will you accept that in exchange?
You got me. Fair and square.
Hey, don't move.
Relax, Eddy. Just getting the map like you asked.
I said, hold on.
I am. Well, hand it over.
Well, now, you told me not to move. Looks like you're gonna have to come get it.
Daddy, come on.
That seemed irresponsible. I don't think I would have. I think I would have been like, hey, let's figure this out. Like go, civilized go. Adults. Chapter 8, The Drowned City. Who's shooting at me? Please stop. I implore you to cease fire. Well, since you act nicely, no problem. I don't have any frickin' ammo. And wait a second. Last time when I was captured, we didn't have any ammo. Grenade? Oh, shut up, Elena. You're not helping. What the hell was moving? Did he just roll over? What was that, like a 12-foot drop? How did I miss? Oh, that's embarrassing. I can't believe you guys all saw that. Oh! Whoa! Shotgun City! Gonna blow you up, yeah! Michael Bolton, yeah! Using a shotgun, yeah! Oh, yeah!
Come on, open the door. Let me in. Oh, and the hair, my chinny chin, blah, 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 blah. I forget how it goes, but I think all the pigs die at the end.
Oh, shit, someone left a jet ski!
No kidding. You know, I should have turned before the bridge.
Yeah. Yeah, you should have.
That's very funny.
Oh, come here a minute. I want to show you something.
Is it a homemade porno of you and your ex-boyfriend?
I think so works.
Uh-huh.
It is. Oh, great.
Check this out. Okay, see this building in the harbor?
No. Yes.
That's where all the boats coming into the colony would have unloaded their cargo.
I figured that out
so
already.
So if the El Dorado treasure came to this island, it would have had to have come through here.
Which helps us how?
Wait a minute, what was that?
What?
Rewind it.
It was my finger on the lens, sorry. Yeah? I'm a shitty photographer.
Stop.
Uh-huh.
Right there. That's our ticket out of here. Come on.
Our ticket out of here? Are you giving up?
Yes.
Maybe you hadn't noticed, but we're kind of outnumbered.
We're doing fine so far.
I don't really
Elena,
think so.
I don't need your bullet-riddled corpse on my conscience. Let's go.
Oh, please. You quit if you want to, but don't use me as an excuse.
Fine. It's me, okay? I am quitting. Are you coming or not?
So that's it. You're just gonna forget about the treasure and forget about Drake?
I'd rather be alive.
God damn it. This is not worth dying over.
Okay. Okay. Listen, either way, we have to head back to the harbor. Don't worry about it. We can argue about it later. It'll be great.
Can we have makeup sex after that?
Wait.
I love you.
This time, I drive.
That makes sense too, yes.
Okay.
Perhaps we're not ready for that stage of our relationship.
Oh great, Kawasaki time! Kawabunga! I love a good jet ski. My family owns one. I get a chance to go on it usually like once or twice a summer up Lake Winnipesaukee here in New Hampshire. Unfortunately, not this past year, though. I mean, the weather was kind of crappy, and I don't even think we bothered to put it in. It was one of those things like, hey, we can go through all the trouble, get the thing clean, get it gassed up, put it in the lake, but we have to take it out, like, in 3 days anyway. So we didn't get a chance to go on it this year, but I have a lot of great memories on the jet ski. I remember this one time I was on it with my friend, and we hit a giant wave after going up kind of off like a jump, so to speak. And, you know, we came out of the water, and we came back into the water. Literally, the entire jet ski went underwater. And just a huge wave consumed the entire thing. And that was fun, and also really scary, because I didn't know what was going on, and it was kind of You kind of fear for your life sometimes when you take a giant, like, you know, 2,000-pound machine completely underwater with you. It can be frightening. But it turned out to be totally fine, and we kept on driving, and it was a lot of fun. Just like I'm going to do right here. Come on, keep driving, keep driving. Over the ramp. Whoa, that was pretty lame. I'm sorry, that was kind of disappointing.
There it is.
There what is?
Yeah, now we just got to find a way in.
You know, I read a story once about a cursed ancient treasure. You don't suppose that...
Please don't tell me you believe in that stuff.
I'm just saying, something bad happened here. The whole colony doesn't just up and vanish.
I mean, it could.
Yeah.
You don't know.
Well, how do you explain it? Thanks.
Oh, look at those wet pants. Elena's a sexy lady.
Looks like that cable would get us up there.
Oh,
check it out.
Interesting.
And keep an eye on our ride.
Oh.
See if you can figure a way to get us to that tower.
What kind of bullshit is that? Hey, I'll keep an eye on the jet ski that no one's going to bother to steal because everyone else has one. But yeah, I'll just stay here and you can go murder a dozen people. All the goddamn hard work in this game. If I do not get laid at the end of this adventure, Elena, I am going to be very, very upset. Because you know at the end of Indiana Jones, Indy and Marion totally boned. They totally boned. You know how I know? Because Shia LaBeouf. That's how I know.
I got him.
Die, die, die!
Oh, boy. All right.
Whoa! Grenade launcher! Hey, come on! How many shots does it take to kill you, jackholes? Alright, so I got a big old grenade launcher here. Oh, oopsies. Sorry, did I ruin your afternoon? That's for screwing up my jet ski! That thing was an authentic Kawasaki, you jerk!
This could help.
This could help. As we press on into the wilderness. We've got him now. No, you don't. That's what your other 400 friends said, and they're all dead now. Learn a lesson and give up. God, you guys are jerks. Oh, that was a big guy. That was a big guy.
This is what I'm talking about.
All right, would you stop shooting at me so I can... Take a breather. Gotta regain my chroma key. Good shooting, Drake. Alright, so we're supposed to just, I guess, clear this area and then circle back to pick up Elena. So where are we going? Is that a treasure? I do believe it is. It is the Silver Frog 9 of 60. What a terrific treasure hunter you have turned out to be, Mr. Drake. Thanks, Howard. Always a pleasure to have you on Game Time. Alright, so I think we can go this way-ish? Oh, there's a fucking staircase right here. How did I not see that? Stop hopping up and down like a Looney Tune and get up there. Whoa! Look at me, I can jump up and down! Derp-a-derp-a-derp! What's this? I'll stick to the gun. So there's Elena over there. So that's where we have. We just kind of went around this whole area. And now we're going this way.
His name is Nate Drake. This is his theme song. He's killing henchmen and climbing platforms. He rides a jet ski and shoots a shotgun to save his girlfriend, whose name is Fisher. He looks for treasure, destroys some ruins with his friend Sully because he loves gold.
The Nate Drake theme song, only on Game Time.
You're dead. Alright, yep! Oh, there's a vine there. I didn't even know what I was jumping onto. I was just jumping. I knew that some game would fix it. Oh, okay, it's just a big giant door. Yes! All Elena has to do now is good. Bring the jet ski around, and we begin with chapter number 9. To the tower! Get to the tower! Oh, that's gonna hurt your brush.
You okay?
Oh, I'm fine. My balls will be in great shape for later, honey. All right, here we go. To the tower.
Take him out, Elena.
Take him out? So why am I doing it? Why do I have to control the take him out, Elena part? The game seems contradictory there. It should be, if Elena's gonna do it, then that should not be me. I don't control Elena. I control Drake. This game is, I'm Drake, not Elena. If I was Elena, I would press whatever button that makes my shirt come off and then have sex with Drake, because that's the happy ending to this title. And I feel like we should just hurry up and get there. I mean, the sexual tension is just, it's palpable. You can taste it. I mean, if this was a movie, there would definitely be like that huggy kissy sex scene at the end. You know there would be. There's no question. All right, I'm losing a lot of my health here. Oh, why did Elena die too? That's a curious thing. All right, took him out. Took out those guys. Took out that guy. Took out that douche. Whoa, just follow the path back to his rocket launcher and... Who else is shooting at me? Oh, there's a guy up there. If it wasn't for the muzzle flashes, I would be very, very lost. All right, I remember this part. You shoot that giant weight, and then the thing goes away. All right. Now that all the dudes are dead, I can go right through this opening. And we get to dismount.
You've got to get to that tower. I'll meet you back at the customs house.
Part of me kind of wishes this entire game took place on a jet ski like that. Was it a GameCube game? N64? Wave Runner? Oh, please tell me someone knows what I'm talking about. There was a game on Nintendo. It was a launch title for whatever console it was. And I think it was a launch title for the N64. And I think the game was called Wave Runner. And it was a game where you just raced jet skis. And the game was totally awesome. I don't think I ever owned it, but I'm pretty sure I rented it, like, a couple times. Or maybe my friend owned it, because I remember playing it definitely more than once over a period of time that would not be of normal rental variety.
His name is Nate Drake. This is his theme song. He's killing henchmen and climbing platforms. He looks for treasure, destroys some ruins with his friend Sully because he loves gold. Nate Drake, he's gonna kill you now. Yeah.
Let's stand out into the open and let him shoot at us. I guess I'm just gonna go right through this water and hope that I can take these guys out. There are a lot of dudes here. All right, that guy's dead. A couple of grenades ought to do it. Come on! You guys stop throwing grenades at me? Don't like it.
All right, we'll stop. We thought it over and, we're gonna be a little more considerate in the upcoming firefight state.
That guy seriously not die? You're still alive. Jesus, get out of here. Let's climb up here and see what's going on. No, you're not. I am not yours. I don't like that the controller doesn't rumble when I use the Uzi. It's weird. Like, I need that tactile feedback to know that, like, the game works. I feel like the game's broken when it doesn't rumble. And in some respects, you can kind of say that it is. Like, it should rumble. It's an Uzi, you know? I mean, I understand it's a smaller kick weapon, but you would still feel some force feedback on it. I'm just climbing on these because I'm pretty sure that's what I'm supposed to do. Anytime there's, like, weird pillars and shit, the object of Uncharted is to climb on top of them in some order of sequence until you get to another spot.
Or could we have just gone underneath? Nope, there is a gate there. Okay, now that we're on the other side of this area, unfortunately for now for me, that'll have to do it for this episode of Game Time. But stay tuned for the next video where we will explore this area, get in another firefight, initiate Chapter 10, the Customs House, and stay on the search for El Dorado. As always, thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.